minus 15 degrees Celsius. And from Kanto to western Japan, the temperature will remain lower than 10 degrees in the afternoon, and in the evening it will be as cold as the morning.
The regional forecast in Kyushu, Okinawa, Chugoku and Shikoku, some areas will have snow or rain early in the morning and at night. Skies will be clearing in many places during the daytime. Overnight lows and daytime highs will be about the same as they were today. The lows will be 3 degrees or lower in many places and the highs will be around 10 degrees. In Kansai, Tokai and Hokuriku, some areas in Kansai and Tokai will have snow overnight, but skies will start to clear afterwards. Hokuriku will have snow on and off accompanied by thunder in some places. Overnight lows will be 3 degrees or lower. Daytime highs will be 10 degrees or lower. The chill will continue. The daytime high will be 5 to 6 degrees in Hokuriku. In Kanto, Koshinetsu and Shizuoka, skies will be mostly clear. It may snow in some places on the mountains of northern Kanto in the afternoon. Niigata will have snow on and off accompanied by thunder in some places. Overnight lows will be 0 degrees in Tokyo and around 3 degrees below freezing in inland areas. Daytime highs will be around 10 degrees. It'll be 3 degrees in Niigata. In Tohoku and Hokkaido, the Japan Sea coast will have snow on and off. The skies will be clearing along the Pacific coast. Overnight lows and daytime highs will be lower than they were today. The low in Morioka will be minus 7 degrees. The highs in Tohoku will be 5 degrees or lower and minus 5 degrees in Asahikawa. The 7-day forecast from Sapporo to Tokyo, Sunday night through Monday, will have rain or snow, also on the Pacific coast, including Sendai and Tokyo. A strong cold air mass will flow in afterwards, causing rough weather on Tuesday and onwards in northern Japan and Hokuriku. From Nagoya to Naha, Sunday to Monday will have cold rain, also along the Pacific coast. The chill will intensify on Tuesday and onwards, bringing a lot of snow along the Japan sea coast. Fukuoka too will have snow on Tuesday, Nagoya will also have snow on Wednesday.
Sports, day 5 of the Neo Grand Simba tournament. Hikuyo faced Yoko Zuna Grand Champion Kakuyo. Before the tournament began, we put the spotlight on Hikuyo, one to watch as he's made a comeback to the tournament to Komusubi, fourth highest ranked. Hikuyo had never beaten Kakuyo in their past 7 matches. Here's their bout from today. Hikuyo mounted the charge from the beginning. Didn't allow Kakuyo to fight his sumo. He pulled down Kakuyo. He says he could make a strong initial charge. He says he'd be patient and do his best in each bout to come. Next bout we're looking at is between Shodai and Mitakeyumi, both former student champions. The young hopefuls of the sumo world were rivals in their university years. Newly ranked Shodai is 24 years old. He's off to a good start with his trademark belt gripping techniques. He was determined to win against Mitakeyumi, who's a year younger and reached the Makuuchi division first. Shodai forced out Mitakeyumi for his third win. And he says he wants to continue at this pace.
Now the results of some of the bouts. Toyohibiki pushed out Takekaze. Sadanomi forced out Endo.
Takayasu beat Gakamaru with an all-round draw. Toyonushima forced out Okinomi. Yoshikaze beat Goeido. Kotoshogeku forced out Tochinoshin, and Hakuho beat Aoyama with an all-round draw.
The National Table Tennis Championship, 6th grader Tomotaro Harimoto plays a candidate for the Olympic Games in Rio de Janeiro. Harimoto is the youngest player to reach the fourth round. The strategy of his opponent, Kokiniwa, was to not consider Harimoto as an elementary schoolboy. First game, Niwa deliberately played soft shots to upset Harimoto's powerful shots. Harimoto had been expecting the pace to be swift, lost his rhythm, scored only 1 point due to repeated errors. Still, he continued to mount a strong challenge. He stayed on the offensive right through to the end. He lost in straight games. He seemed to have learned a lesson. Harimoto says he was able to score well when he was on the offensive, so he'll try to use more such shots when he faces top players in the future.
It was a heated rally. The boy lost the game, but he earned good experience.
The Japanese under-23 men's national soccer squad beat North Korea in the first game of the Asian final qualifying round for the 2016 Summer Olympic Games. Japanese players did light training after their game against North Korea yesterday. Naomichi Ueda scored in the match. He was smiling during training, as well as the other players. At 5 minutes into the first half of yesterday's game, Japan's defender, Ueda, scored a goal. After this goal, North Korea went on the offensive and created a lot of scoring chances. But the Japanese squad held on. Japan didn't allow North Korea to score and won the match. The country is now in first place in Group B. Soccer commentator Masakuni Yamamoto was head coach of the under-23 squad at the Athens Olympic Games. Yamamoto says the entire Japanese team was determined to beat North Korea to get 3 points for a victory. He says Japan's defense was stable and that the squad had a relatively good game. He pointed out some of the problems, though, with Japan's attack. He says he felt that the players tried to carry the ball quickly into their opponent's goal mouth, but what they lacked was creative ideas to score once they were in the penalty area. Yamamoto says he expects the team to gradually get better. He says he wants the head coach to use players who are at the top of their game. Their next match is in 2 days. Ryosuke Yamanaka says the Japanese players now have more confidence after beating North Korea. He says they're aiming to win the group league stage and end in first place, and this goal will unite them.
In tennis, Kei Nishikori has talked about his aspirations ahead of the Australian Open, which starts on Monday. He's aiming to win his first Grand Slam. Nishikori says he is gaining rhythm, getting better as he plays more matches. Nishikori today was checking his return shots, concentrated on preparations today. It's just 4 days before the start of the tournament. Nishikori's made it to quarter-final twice in the Australian Open, and he's ranked 7th seed this year. Nishikori says doing well in Melbourne will give him more self-confidence, so he wants to win.
He
Nishikori says he will play powerfully and aggressively as he can to win his first Grand Slam title. He will always